Recently, the Cambridge Times, in the United Kingdom, reported on new finds of witchcraft trials in recently uncovered documents. Tales of magic and murder are revealed in historical records of Cambridgeshire witch trials in a research project by the Cambridge University Library. 2 centuries of Isle of Ely court records shine a light on the most serious crimes in the region's past, from theft and assault to murder and witchcraft. Archivists working on the records have not yet reached the period when witch hunts were at their peak, but they have still uncovered a number of interesting cases. Sally Kent, assistant archivist, says, "The first time I spotted a witch, I felt excited about it. It was one of those things you know about, but until you see it in writing, you can't quite believe it, because the experience is so removed from our lives now. So far in the Elizabethan roles, we have found 8 women who have been accused of witchcraft, and it seems quite peculiar to us. We can't really get our heads around it." The roles feature a rogues gallery of defendants, covering a period of 1557 to 1775, when being found guilty could lead to the death penalty. Ms. Kent says that when a death couldn't be explained, witchcraft was sometimes blamed. She says, "It seems peculiar to us, but I think it is a way when they had unexplained deaths, they had to come up with a reason for it, and that's probably why witchcraft appears in the records. Normally you find the accused as a single woman. She will be spinster, and she will be accused of practicing witchcraft, and causing harm to a named person, or in one case, a goose and a cow." That case was one Alice Wilcox, of Dettington, who in 1586 is accused of using her enchantments, and her magical powers, on a goose and a cow, causing them to die. "I think what probably happened, was these livestock died unexpectedly. There wasn't an obvious cause for it, so the person who had lost the animals, was looking for some kind of recompense," says Sally. "It seems unusual to us as an accusation, but she might have poisoned their food, or something. On the other hand, she could just be a spinster living in the village that these men didn't like. They'd had a run-in with her, and she was an easy target." Other cases include Joan Dowlange of Ely, a spinster who was indicted on August 4, 1573, because she used, exercised and practiced enchantments, and magical arts, on Richard Parker to vex, disturb, and make him ill, contrary to statute. She pled not guilty, and the verdict wasn't recorded. More intriguing is the case of Elizabeth Tillingham, of Ely, a spinster who was described as being a witch as well of men as beasts, as her occupation. She was indicted on August 20, 1595, because she used, exercised and practiced enchantments, magical arts, and witchcraft, on Elizabeth Lawn at Ely, causing her to languish and die. This was the second time she had been accused of witchcraft, although she was found not guilty both times. Sally says, "She's given that title, almost as if that's how she was known, in the local community. The first time I saw it, I had to look it up to translate it properly from the Latin. Given that expression used to describe her, she obviously had quite some reputation. It must have been quite a hard life for her, I think."